What's up, guys? My name is Chris. I'm a group fitness instructor at the University of North Florida Student Wellness Complex, and today I'll be leading you through a Tabata style workout. This workout will consist of 7 exercises that will be performed for 8 rounds apiece. How this is going to work is going to be 20 seconds of work and then 10 seconds of rest until 8 rounds of that is completed. That'll give you 4 minutes of work for each exercise. Then between each exercise you want to take a 1 to 2 minute break, grab some water real quick before beginning that next exercise. So before we get started, I'll take you through a breakdown of each of the exercises that I've listed, and then we'll get into a warm up, do the whole workout, and then we'll cool down and stretch at the end. So our first exercise today is going to be the devil press. So for this, you're going to want to take some dumbbells, or if you have like a backpack or something, you can put some weight in. That'll work too. But what you're going to want to do is grab your object, whatever you're using. You're just going to come down to the floor, keep your feet back behind you, do one to a push-up, and come back up, and then you're pressing it up overhead. And then you go back into the next one. So it's kind of like a burpee if you've done those before. If you want to make it a little bit easier for yourself, just go ahead and take that, whatever object you're using, and you can put it on like a higher object instead of going all the way to the floor. And then you can kind of just like step your feet back and then stand back up and press it overhead as well. If you want to make it a little bit tougher, you can just increase the intensity of that movement. Try to do it as fast as you can for the whole period of the 20 seconds. So that's the devil press. Next up, we're going to do single leg lateral hops. So for this, you're going to do a hop on 1 foot. Over an object or over a line on the ground. So if I'm going to use the dumbbell for this, you're just going to get up on 1 foot and then just hop over back and forth like that. And what you want to do is you're going to do 4 of those rounds with one leg and then 4 of the other rounds remaining with the other leg. You can either stagger it, you can do your left leg, then your right leg, right leg, or you can just do 4 of the left leg and then 4 of the right leg. Whichever one you want to do. Making it easier, it's just, lowering the height of that object. If you just want to do a line on the floor, hop over that, that's fine. If you can't hop over on 1 foot, that's okay too. You can just use 2 feet and just try to go as fast as you can with that. An easy way to make that a little bit tougher is just increasing the height of that object to make it a little bit tougher for you. So. That's going to be the single leg lateral hops. Next up, we're going to do push-ups with an oblique crunch. So it's going to be similar to a push-up and a mountain climber if you've done those before. So what you're going to want to do is come down into that high plank. I'll do it from 2 different angles in case you can't see. But what you're going to do is you're going to bring your opposite knee to your opposite elbow. So I'm going to take my right knee to my left elbow, or as close as I can get it, and then left knee to my right elbow, and then you're going down to a push-up. Once you come back up, doing that crunch again, and then push-up. So I'll do it from the side real quick so you can see that from another way. So crunch, crunch, push-up. You want to make it easier on yourself, just do 1 crunch at a time and then go down to your knees for that push-up. So do your crunch as far as you can go, and then just drop down to the knees, come back up, and then go back into those crunches. Make it a little bit tough on yourself, just increase that intensity of it. Really just try to get that speed up, crunch, crunch, push up. You can do like a plyo push up if you want to clap whenever you come up off the ground. That'll make it tougher for you. And if you're unable to do those on your knees, you can try using the wall or something as assistance. That's going to be a little bit tough to get those crunches in, so I probably recommend using like a couch or something if you can have that. But that'll help you out a little bit more than you always do. Next up, we're going to do squat jumps. So what you're going to do is you're just going to go into a squat. So your feet hip width apart, south side hip width apart. You're just going to push those hips back, almost like you're going to sit into a chair. So in that chair, and then what you're going to do is you're going to squeeze your glutes and push off of your heel, and then jump up into the air. So doing a couple of those, it should be something like this. And making that tougher. You can turn it into like a squat jump if you want, or not a squat jump, but a tuck jump if you want to. So whenever you come up, you can bring those knees up, or making it a little bit easier. If you can't go all the way down into a full squat, you can use a chair. Just sit down onto that chair and then sit back up, and you can just do like a little hop, whatever's easiest for you. Next up, we're gonna do flutter kicks. So what you're gonna do is lay down on the floor. You can put your hands up to the side of you. You gotta raise your feet up off the floor about 6 inches or so, and then you're just gonna chop your feet back and forth. It may make it a little bit easier just to put your hands underneath your butt. You can do it that way. The key is you don't want to have your feet like way up here, and you don't want to have your feet hitting off the floor like this. You want to keep them in the air at all times. Just chopping those back and forth. If you want to make it a little bit tougher, you can kind of like sit up with it. Engage those abs a little bit more. Next up, we're going to do a lateral lunge with a shoulder raise. So you can do these with cans, your backpack that you used before. Whatever you use for the devil press can be used for this as well. So what you're going to do, you're going to come over here, get your feet a little bit past hip width apart. You might want to go a little bit wide with this. Hold your object out in front of you. You kind of want to keep your feet out a little bit. You're just going to lunge over to one side, and then whenever you lunge over, you're going to raise those up, and then come back up, lunge over to the other side. Shoulder raise up, come back up. So if you don't have any weight, that's okay. Just go over to that side lunge, raise up your hands, squeeze for a second, and then come back over to the other side, squeeze when you come up. Then lastly, you're gonna take those dumbbells. If you don't have dumbbells, you can just use your hands. Or if you have like some old water bottles full of sand, that'll work too. Cans probably not the best idea to use for this because they might break. But what you're gonna do is you're gonna go into, I'll do this two different ways as well. You're gonna go into that push-up position, and then you're just gonna throw them up like so, alternating each time. So from the other angle, just like this. And increasing the weight of that is really going to be your main thing to make it more challenging. If you don't have any weight, that's okay. Just use your hands. If you're not using any weight though, I would recommend when you pull your hand up, just get that, try to squeeze your lat right here on the side of your back. Just try to squeeze at the top, hold it for a second, and then go back down. So that's all 7 of our exercises for today. I'm going to grab some water real quick, get my timer going, and we'll go ahead and do that warm-up. So if you need to do anything right now before you get started, go ahead and pause the video, and then we'll go ahead and get going here in just a second. I'll have the timer based on the Tabata timer that I'll be using for the workout, so you'll kind of be able to get used to it while we do the warm-up. So let me go through that setup real quick. So about 15 seconds or so, we'll get going. The first exercise we're going to do for a warm-up is going to be jumping jacks. And I'll shout out each one before we get started. So here we go. Jumping jacks. Just going to do 20 seconds of these. Once we get done with these, we're going to go into high knees. Just a little bit longer here. Alright, high knees coming up next. Here we go. Get those knees up. As high as you can go. Go whatever pace is good for you. I forgot about the rest timer. Here we go. Now we're high knees. Here we go. So there's a 10 second rest timer in between each of these little intervals. key here is to get some sweat flowing, not to wear yourself out just yet. All right, quick little rest so that buzzer goes off. We'll have our 10-second rest period, and then we'll go into the next exercise. Next one's gonna be butt kickers, so get those feet up behind you, try to kick that butt. Should be breathing somewhat heavy. Get that sweat flowing, get that body ready to work out. All right, here we go. Another little rest period. Next up, we're gonna do toy soldiers or just kicks it down as you can. So, right leg to the left hand, left leg to the right hand. So, here we go. Try to get those legs up in the air. Here we go, another rest period. We're gonna go back through all those exercises we just did. So we'll start from the top and do jumping jacks again. Here we go. So this is pretty much exactly how the workout's gonna work, except you're only gonna be doing one exercise at a time. So 20 seconds of exercise and then a rest. You're gonna do 7 more rounds of that. All right, here we go. Another rest period. If you're not breathing heavy yet, go ahead and try to amp up the intensity. If you can't keep conversation going, then maybe slow down a little bit. High knees, here we go. And then we'll do toy soldiers once again. Here we go, back kickers. About another minute, we'll get going. Here we go. 3 seconds. Double press. Here we go. round one. A little rest period. And round two, here we go. About a minute and a half. If you need longer than that, go ahead and pause the video. But don't take any longer than a 3-minute break at most. Next one up is going to be those single leg lateral hops. So you're going to want to grab an object that you can jump over. If you don't have an object, just take a line from the floor. That works too. Biggest thing here is you don't want to use just one leg the whole time. You're gonna use left leg for four of the rounds, right leg for the other four. You're gonna alternate them each time. That works too. That's probably what I'm gonna do. So we're gonna about 45 more seconds or so. Here we go, about 15 seconds. We're going to go on to the next exercise. Single leg, lateral hops. Start on whatever side you want to. Just remember, four of each. Four left leg, four right leg. Here we go. Two, one, go. You can't do the single leg, that's okay. Just go ahead and do the 2 feet. Just try to amp up the intensity as much as you can. Little break.
Nice.
I'm going to go ahead and switch over to that right leg this time. You can do the same or just do 3 more with that left leg. However you want to break it up. Quick little break. You ready for that next one? I'm gonna switch back over to that left leg now. Here we go, 2, 1, let's go. Try to give me at least 5 while we're going back. Complete.
Nice.
Switch back over to that right leg. There you go. All right. Halfway through, you should either be completely done with one of your legs or halfway through each one. Alright, 2 more left. Almost there. Push right here. Give me at least 5 over and back, so 5 on each side of your object. Here we go, quick water break. Once again, better. 1 to 2 minute break, no more than 3, and then we'll get back at it. The next exercise is going to be push-ups with an oblique crunch, so you won't need any equipment for the next one. Go ahead and hydrate real quick. go about 15 seconds. So once again, push up with the oblique crunch. So I'm gonna do crunch, crunch, push up. About 5 more seconds, here we go. 2, 1, go! Let's see at least 5 of these. Alright, round 1, complete. 7 more of those. Let's aim for about 3 to 5 of those. If we do more, that's great. Somewhere in that range, so. Here we go, round 2. About to get on that round 3 real quick. Here we go. Remember, if you can't do the full push-up, that's okay. Scoot out your knees, or you can use like a little incline if you need to. About halfway through, just about. Three rounds left.
Rest.
Round 6 complete. We got 2 more. Hang in there. So let's get rough. That's it, I guess that's kind of the rounds. So, my bad. Quick little 1 to 2 minute break. Extend to more than 3. And then we'll get back on those squat jumps. Back out for the exercises almost. Next up, so we do the squat jumps. So, squat down, jump up, tight and go. Alright, about 15 seconds, we're going to go on to the squat jumps. Here we go, 5 seconds. 2, 1, here we go, round 1. Almost halfway through these.
Starting session.
All right, about 20 seconds, we're gonna go into those flutter kicks. So you're gonna be on the ground for this one, on your back. Drop those feet back and forth in the air, about 6 inches off the ground. All right, here we go, 3, 2, 1, go!
Lateral lunges with the shoulder raise.
starting session.
All right, here we go, about 20 seconds. We'll get going with those lateral raises. Lateral lunges and shoulder raises. About 10 more seconds. About three each side. Alright, round one. A little rest. Here we go, round two. At least two to three on each side.
working session.
Right, here we go, about 25 seconds. We'll get going on those Renegade Rows. This will be our last exercise. So once again, dumbbells down here, push-up position, raise one up, back down, up, squeeze, down, back and forth. If you don't have weights, that's okay. You can either go on your knuckles or just on your hands, just raise one up, squeeze at the top, and then go back down. Here we go. Try to get at least three of those every time. Aim for about five. Rousey, please, just six more to go and we're done for the day. Hang in there. grab another sip of water or so. Try to start calming that breathing down. Get those deep nasal breaths going. Try to really bring that heart rate down. Get that deep, good nasal breathing. Super humid out here today, but still got it done, that's all right. So, here we go. I'm just gonna go both feet together. You're gonna go straight down to the floor. Grab your ankles, your feet, wherever you can touch, as far down as you can go. Hold it there. Try taking a couple deep breaths and get deeper into that stretch. Slow, deep breaths. All right, we'll go ahead and spread our feet apart now. You can take both hands down to that left side. Same thing, try to get down to the floor or your ankle. Keep that leg straight. As far as you can go. Hold it. Breathe, try to get deep down to that stretch. All right, we'll go ahead and go to the right side now. Both hands down to the middle, as far back as you can reach, and hold it there. Try to breathe deeply, get further back if you can. You can put your palms on the floor even better. As far back as you can go, hold it there. All right, we're gonna go down to a squat real quick. You're gonna just put your feet in together a little bit. Put both elbows or both fists on the floor or hands on the floor. Both elbows on the insides of your knees. You're just gonna push them out as far as you can. Maybe a little tough if you're sweaty. Push it until you feel that tension in the hold. To our butt, sit on the floor. What you want to do here, put your left leg out. You're going to take your right knee over it. Then you're going to take your left elbow and put it on the outside of that right knee. You're going to push that knee to your left side of your body. Should have one hand behind you. Just try to look over that shoulder as you're pushing that knee across. You should be looking behind you. Try to get deep down in that stretch. You should feel it in your outer hip. Holding a little longer. Alright, we'll go ahead and switch over to the other side. So, right leg straight, left leg over, right elbow pushing that left knee to your right side, looking over that back left shoulder. Keep pushing. Once again, you should feel that in your outer left hip. Again, for good measure, we'll go ahead and do a butterfly stretch. Bring those feet in together. You're gonna want to grab your ankles, grab your feet, and then put your elbows on those knees and push them down and out. And hold. Just feel that tension, just hold there. Keep holding a little longer. Go ahead and stand up now. Find you a pole or something to hold on to if you need to. Some kind of bar, just pull up your right leg behind you. Hold your ankle, hold your foot. Then stretch out that quad, the front of that thigh. The further you lean forward into it, the deeper you'll get into that stretch. The more you'll feel it in the front of that thigh. side, but then switch over to the left side. Same thing here, just try to breathe deep. Keep deep down to that thigh, stretch it out. Alright, now we're going to take that left or right arm across your body, hook it with your left arm. You're stretching out that shoulder, the right shoulder. You're going to hold it here. Thank you guys for joining me today. It's been my pleasure to do another video with you guys. Once again, go follow UNF Recwell for more workouts each day, workouts of the week, all kinds of different workouts, booty blasts, there's Tai Chi if you want to do some meditation, yoga classes, anything you can find on there. Follow the UNF Recwell Facebook page as well. All right, we're going to switch over to left side. So plug that left arm across your left arm across your body, hug with your right arm. A little bit longer. All right, now we're going to take that left hand.
You're going to put it slowly back. Take that right arm. Grab that left elbow and pull it back behind you. You can stretch out that tricep. Keep holding. Keep holding. Alright, now we'll switch over to the left side.